Hello my friends, welcome back to Pickyplans lab. Here I have sample of crushed gold ore, and as you know, the best way to process this material is using industrial method, which involves using high temperature and lead metal to oxidize base metals and recover gold through cupellation process. Also, cyanidation process can be used, but it's a good method for low grade ore with gold content of lower 15 ppm. But when my friend gave me this sample, he claimed that gold concentration in this sample is 50 ppm, which means this ore contains 50 grams of gold per ton. This sample is full of sulfides, including iron sulfide, which is known as a fool's gold. This will cause lots of problems and reduce gold yield. In order to fix that, before recovering gold, this should be roasted at about 500 degrees Celsius in order to oxidize all sulfides to sulfates. Here I have already tried to dissolve 50 grams of this sample in aqua regia, but as you know, iron sulfide in this sample will consume lots of nitric acid, which is supposed to dissolve gold. This is one of that couple of reasons that the final yield will be very low in presence of sulfides. This is microscopic picture of iron sulfide pieces. This material would be attracted to a magnet due to its high content of iron. Also, I have another sample that you may think it's a rock, but I should say it's a slag from high temperature processing of that gold sample. My friend managed to get only 5 grams of gold per ton, which is ridiculous, because he didn't do the sulfurization process and this rocky material is formed, which is called mat. This is melted base metal sulfide, such as iron sulfide. Iron sulfide is a porous material which holds gold inside and prevents from transferring gold to the metal bead at the bottom of crucible while melting. This is the largest issue you will face if you don't desulfurize ore per your melting. But it's not a big deal, this can be fixed, and I will recover gold from this slag in my next videos when I make my furnace. This piece of slag, or better to say mud, also attracts to the magnets. By the way, I am still going to test this solution with Stannous chloride to see what would happen after addition of Stannous chloride. And here I have a Stannous chloride. I start adding these. Still there is no color change, but it's getting a bit darker, and that yellow color is disappearing. There we go, it turned a bit black, but you cannot say for sure that this is gold. That's why we can't use a Stannous chloride to determine gold in ore. I have read different sources that lowest gold concentration which can be detected with naked eye from a Stannous chloride test is 4 ppm. But in my experience, it would be only 16 ppm that you can say for sure that gold is in the solution. And in this test, it seems concentration is lower than 16 ppm. That's why I came up with the idea of concentrating gold in order to see if it's possible to be tested with Stannous chloride. I decided to concentrate 180 grams of sample of gold ore and then attempting again to dissolve gold and test it with Stannous chloride. By assuming 50 ppm gold concentration in this sample, we would get maximum about 9 mg of gold in this 180 grams of gold ore, which is definitely low trace of gold. I really hope I can concentrate this.
This is my gold concentrator machine, which I've made in previous videos, and now I'm going to concentrate this gold sample with this stuff. Before doing that, I need to grind all particles in this, and I have about 180 grams of sample here, which has a high pyrite or iron sulfide content, and predicted to get about only 9 milligrams of gold from this sample. To do so, first I need to grind all this stuff here using a mortar and pestle. And also I need to mention that these all shiny particles, which is iron sulfide or pyrite, has a density of about 5 gram per cubic centimeter of this material, and gold density is something around 18 to 19 grams per cubic centimeter. So it's pretty easy to wash out this stuff with a pan, gold pan, or any other concentrator machine, which now I'm going to use this concentrator machine. But before that, since there is some gold stuck in this crystalline sulfide, I need to crush them. Using a mortar and pestle wasn't really a good idea, so I came up with the idea of using this grinder in order to get as fine as possible powder from this stuff. Right, this is the finest powder I could get from my grinder. Not bad. By the way, maybe not 100%, but we can still extract some gold by this mesh here. So let's turn on gold concentrator machine and adjust the speed to the desired rate. I hope some gold stuck in this sluice here. And to prevent to reduce water surface tension, I'm going to add some surfactant. I have some silicone base surfactant here. This surfactant would help to sink gold powder at the bottom much easier. And after mixing, I'm going to add this to the concentrator machine. Now it's ready to be added to the concentrator machine. I'm just going to release it so easy in water to help that water stream decide what should remain and what should not. And after about 45 minutes, I think it's been washed just enough, and turn It's time to turn the machine off and let it the water surface come down, and the gold, the possible gold dust shows up at the bottom of this bowl here with the sluice. The water in this bowl will came out from the input housing from the pump, and it's returned back into this part. And here you can see all the washed dust and mud from this sample, and there should be left behind any possible gold in this sample. I really hope this is gold here, but not some dirt or so. I will figure it out soon.
After testing this sample with aqua regia followed by a Stannous chloride test, I realized I've run machine with a speed higher than needed, and some gold washed away and went into the bucket underneath the bowl. So I had to pan heavier materials in the bucket, but I'm still lucky since majority of unwanted materials have been washed away and transferred to the big vessel.
I came up with the idea of panning the powder which been washed away in the bucket of gold concentrator machine. I mean this bucket, I transfer everything to the my gold pan, and after that I got a clean powder which there wasn't any trace of iron sulfide in that, and here it is. I placed it on the hot plate and made some aqua regia. As you can see, still there was some trace of iron sulfate and changed solution color, but as you can see, the majority of powder here is some black sand and other material, regular sand. And after that I tried to dissolve everything in aqua regia, and now I'm gonna to test this batch with Stannous chloride to see if there is any gold. Let's do that. First, to sensitize our test, which gold concentration is low, to prevent dissolving gold, colloidal gold, while testing with Stannous chloride, I'm going to add some sulfamic acid, just try to expel excess nitric acid in this solution and eliminate some chlorine and other oxidizing agent form in this solution, like nitrosyl chloride. And after that I'm going to test this solution. It's been heated on the hot plate, trying to dissolve and eliminate nitric acid. You can see that it started to foam. Let's pick a sample, just enough to make it visible for eye. And here I added just amount of this solution. And now I'm going to add Stannous chloride. And here, as you can see, after addition of some Stannous chloride, that yellow color has gone, and there is only a small hint of pink, orange, with some a bit of dark hint, black hint, or maybe dark blue hint, that we are faced with some platinum in this ore and some gold maybe. But I repeat again that this method is not a reliable method to determine gold from the ore, but it seems I manage to get something from these. If we assume that we have about 20 milliliters of solution here, we have about 1.5 or 1.5 of milligrams gold dissolved in this solution, which is not really possible to drop with chemicals like SMB or iron sulfate either. Let's test it again to see what we will get after sitting for more minutes after eliminating nitric acid. And there we go. Almost same result from second test of this solution. I hope you can see this color change, which is blank to the only a trace of gold in this sample, which is reasonable for chemical testing, which is not at all good idea, but I've managed to do that. As a witness for this test, I'm going to add some tap water and add some Stannous chloride to it just in case of comparison. That Stannous chloride is a bit dark, but it's totally different from this solution, which means we have some precious metals in this solution. It seems a good ore to be processed. And next time, which I've made my furnace, I will take a sample from that ore and I will process that in a total different way, which is an industrial method and with some lead and cupels.
I know it's totally ridiculous idea to determine ore gold content this way, but I just needed to confirm presence of gold, so I did it over and over until all sample consumed. And as you see, it was certainly positive test for gold. So I consider it as a green light to process this ore next time in totally different way using a furnace and cupellation method. There it is. This project is done. Hope you enjoyed. See you next time.